In the standard model of elementary particles, the Higgs field has a non-trivial vacuum expectation value, which spontaneously breaks the SU2 cross U1y gauge symmetry to the U1em gauge symmetry. Quarks, leptons, and gauge fields that exist in our universe gain mass through the spontaneous symmetry breaking. In 2012, the Higgs boson, which had been sought after for many years, was finally discovered at CERN's LHC experiment. This completes all the particles contained in the standard model of particle physics. The standard model is SU3 cross SU2 cross U1y gauge theory. Since SU3 gauge symmetry is not relevant to future discussions, we will focus on SU2 cross U1y gauge symmetry and discuss the Higgs field vacuum expectation value. The Higgs field H is a two-component complex scalar field with SU2 doublet conversion and U1y hypercharge y equals 1. The kinetic term and potential of the Higgs field and the covariant derivative D to the Higgs field H are shown. I2 is a 2x2 identity matrix, G2 is a SU2 gauge coupling constant, and G1 is a U1y gauge coupling constant. It is assumed that the Higgs field H has a non-trivial vacuum expectation value. V is a positive real number, given by the Lagrangian density. By substituting the vacuum expectation value into the first term on the right side of the Lagrangian density, the mass term of the gauge field appears. It is convenient to redefine the gauge fields W and B. Then, the mass term of the Lagrangian density is diagonalized. W plus minus is called a W boson, and Z0 is called a Z boson. The gauge field A has no mass term and remains at zero mass. As expected from this, A is a gauge field corresponding to photons. If the gauge symmetry is not broken, the gauge field has no mass. Therefore, the SU2 cross U1y gauge symmetry is broken to U1em. This is not the only role of the Higgs field. It has another important mission to give mass to quarks and leptons. Let's start with the quark mass generation mechanism.
What plays an important role is the SU3 cross SU2 cross U1y invariant Yoichiro interaction consisting of quark fields Q, D, and Higgs field H.
Here, HC is an abbreviation for the Hermiton conjugate term of the first term on the right side. F is called the Yoichiro coupling constant and is a quantity that expresses the strength of the coupling between the Higgs field and the Fermi field. By replacing the Higgs field H with the vacuum expectation value in the Yoichiro interaction, the mass term for the down-type quark can be obtained. Since the expected vacuum expectation value V over square root 2 of the Higgs field is common, the mass m is proportional to the Yoichiro coupling constant F. From this property, it can be seen that the heavier the quark, the stronger the bond with the Higgs field. However, since the upper component of the vacuum expectation value of the Higgs field is zero, it seems that it is not possible to give mass to the up-type quark of the quark double term. If the Higgs doublet H transforms under SU2, then the H tilde has the same SU2 transformability. From this, we can write the SU3 cross SU2 cross U1y invariant Yoichiro interaction. At this point, it's easy to see how the lepton mass term appears. If the Higgs field is replaced with the vacuum expectation value in the Yoichiro interaction, the mass term of the charged leptons appears. Observations of neutrino oscillations have confirmed that neutrinos also have a very small mass. If the right-handed neutrino nu r is added to the standard model, the neutrino can also acquire mass through the Yoichiro interaction. Also, nu r can have a special Majorana mass term, which is consistent with SU3 cross SU2 cross U1y gauge invariance. Since the neutrino mass is expected to be several eV or less, the Yoichiro coupling constant must have an order of magnitude smaller value of 10 to the minus 11th or less in order to realize such a light mass. Perhaps the neutrino mass is not derived from the Higgs. The origin of the neutrino mass remains a mystery. There is a difference of 300,000 times or more between the Yoichiro coupling constant for electrons and the Yoichiro coupling constant for top quarks, Why there is such a big difference in the magnitude of the Yukawa coupling constant is one of the mysteries left in the Standard Model. When the interaction with the Higgs field is switched off, the masses of all quarks and leptons become zero. At this time, quarks and leptons have a three-generation structure. Why did nature prepare three of the same thing? This is called the generation problem.